Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you what I got from Ulta. And I know this box looks little, but this is expensive. I don't really know if you guys are gonna like these kind of videos, but I know I like watching these kind of videos. So if you do like watching hauls and videos like that, don't forget to give me a like, comment, and subscribe, and let me know in the comment section below. So why don't we just jump on into the video so I can show you guys what I got. So the first thing I got, I actually used on my face right now. I got, and I know I'm in love, I got the Anastasia Amorese Highlighter. You know that everybody was talking about this, and it lived up to the hype. It is definitely worth it. It is so beautiful. Look at that, for one. Look at that. Do you guys see that?
Girl.
If you don't get this today, I don't know what you're doing with your life. I am just saying, this highlighter, it blends so perfectly, and it was definitely worth the hype. Definitely worth it. The next thing that I picked up was the... The next thing that I picked up was the Anastasia Beverly Hills Soft Glam Palette. I really loved this palette. It blended very, very nicely. My only thing about it is they used some shades that were already in the Modern Renaissance palette. Yeah. So one thing I don't like is the fact that they used burnt orange twice. I don't want to buy a $50-something palette and it already have some of the shades that I bought in another palette. That's one thing that I did not like about it, is the fact that they reused some of the shadows, which I get it, it's a soft glam palette, like burnt orange goes perfect, but I don't think that they should have included it in another palette, because I just feel like I wasted some of my money. You know, I do really love this palette. I feel like it's a great palette. But yeah, that's the only thing that I have to say about it. The next thing that I picked up is a MAC blush, because you know Ulta has MAC now. Like, that's crazy. I got this MAC blush, and it is in the shade... Where does it say it at? I'm pretty sure it's in Peaches. I don't know. Yeah. Okay, so it's in the shade Peaches. And I really like peachy blushes. I'm more of a peachy blush kind of person. So, oops. So, that's what it looks like. And, yeah. I feel like everybody needs blush. And the next thing that I picked up is this Tarte Double Duty Shape Tape, the foundation. I heard, like, bad reviews about it. But I'm the type of person who wants to try it themselves, because you never know what works for me might not work for somebody else. So, I am in the shade Light Sand. I love the packaging. It's so cute. But I really like the Tarte, the Rainforest of the Sea foundation. So that's actually my favorite foundation. So I'm just like, why not try it out? And if I don't like it, whatever, I don't like it. But at least I tried. Next thing that I got, and I know I'm so late on this, is the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Bronze from Light to Medium Skin Tones. I know everybody loves this thing, but I could never... I never just got my hands on it. Like, I never just went out of my way to buy it, you know what I mean? But I was shopping, and I was like... why not give it a shot? Oh, I got another foundation. The next thing that I got is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Full Coverage Foundation. And once again, I know I'm late on this, but I've heard amazing reviews, and I had to pick it up just to give it a try. I love Tarte. Tarte is one of my favorite brands. So yeah, had to give that a try. Next thing that I got, and once again, I know I'm super late. I finally had to go and get the NARS Orgasm Blush. It's a great one. Everybody says it's amazing. I never heard any bad reviews about it, so I had to jump on the bandwagon. Next thing I got, of course, Tarte, because if you don't know, like I said before, it's my favorite brand, is the Timeless Smoothing Primer. It's basically a primer base. It's one of my favorites. I ran out of it, so it was time to get another one. The next thing that I picked up is the Milani Make It Last setting spray. I love setting sprays. I have a million one setting sprays. I love trying out different setting sprays. So why not try the Milani one? I love a lot of her products. So if I could find a good, cheap alternative drugstore, I don't even know if you can set it. Yeah, it is drugstore. You can find it at Walmart. Setting spray, why not get it? Last thing that I got is my favorite drugstore foundation, and it's the L'Oreal True Match Lumi foundation, and it's this one, and I have this one already, but I got paler, so I needed to get a lighter one than the one that I have. So I am in the shade W3. But yeah, that's the last product that I got. For today's video, you guys, I really hope that you enjoy these kind of videos. I would love to post videos like this. I'm always shopping, I'm always trying new makeup. So if you guys like seeing videos like this, let me know. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And stay tuned for next week's video. Bye guys, love you.